media and the governments are at it once again. They're making Israelis look all innocent. They're not, even if they're potentially the victims in some of the things, what they've done, you can't just say, oh, look at them, they're all innocent and being attacked. I'm not saying that they should have been attacked, I'm just saying some of the things that we've seen them doing in the Netherlands. The fans, the so-called fans of the football fans, they're chanting things, let the idea win to F the Arabs. There are no schools in Gaza because there are no children left. So the other things that they've been apparently chanting, they're also taking flags down, Palestinian flags down. People starting Israeli flags down, I'm sure they'd have a different reaction. Oh no, we can do what we want. That's the attitude that we've seen. And then people are saying, oh, look at them, they're innocent, stuff like that. Like I said, I'm not saying if they should or shouldn't be attacked, but you're doing these things and saying these things, and then you're not in the illegal pseudo apartheid state of Israel. You can just do what you want. After you see what, not just the Israeli army, what settlers do, you can't just do that. You think you can do that over there and then bring it to other places, that's not going to work. And besides that, not a single Israeli football team should be in any UEFA competition, in any European competition, in any World Cup, in any international competition, Euros, whatever. That's the big story. And also, if that happened, this will be happening. It's not saying that this should happen to them, or it's not saying that we shouldn't find solutions. The solution is that we don't include these teams in any competitions. When you're committing genocide, when you're murdering people, when you're burning people alive in the storm, or when you literally send your ethnic returns and tell people they cannot return, you do not have these teams in any sports competition in the world. You leave them, you isolate them, and then when they realize that nobody cares about them, then they might just think about what they're doing. That's the only reason they think about what they're doing, the money, because of things. And this shows you, this is enough. Remove every single Israeli top, every single football competition, European, international, just remove them. With Russia, it took a few days. I might be exaggerating, but it took a very short amount of time. And maybe because other teams are refusing to play against them. Unfortunately, teams are refusing to play against Israeli teams, but nonetheless, UEFA and all the governing bodies should remove them from competition, and a lot of this will be stopped.